today. He's a fine attorney. He's a fine attorney, but he's starting to take on any case that comes where he can get his mush in the paper.
No,
he
Paul, that's silly.
No, I believe it, right.
No, I could turn down a lot of cases where I get my mush in the paper. Look, Paul, you and I work on some very serious case out in Nassau County, right, together. I mean, you know,
You're a great lawyer, but what's happening, Joe, I'm starting to see a trend now. I'm starting to see the way you look in the morning here.
I had to leave my house at 5:30 a.m.
By the way, Bo, this is on the road that you want to go down. Have you heard from Sid, by the way?
Yeah, Sid who, was he going to say?
Sid?
Have you talked to Sid?
No, not recently.
You haven't?
No, we've exchanged some voicemails.
Okay. Anyway, go ahead. What's wrong?
Nothing. And Sid, the whole thing
is
so damn
Sid. But now?
He absolutely does. Yeah. It's damn Sid.
All right, go ahead, Chris.
The playoffs start today, 1 o'clock. Cardinals and the Padres, the first game. The fans in St. Louis, very, very excited to get things going. Here's the rally yesterday.
Is this the year the Cardinals win it all?
Oh, my God. It sounded a little like Chuck, but here's
the way. Charles' wife, Connie, and his son, Les, were at that rally.
We're in the middle of it.
Well,
oh, my God. Maybe this is Connie, because here's a Cardinal fan ready for the World Series already.
I don't know if I want to see Boston again, but, you know, we'll invite them back, and we'll take them in four. How's that?
Oh, God.
That sounds like Connie.
That was her.
By the way, Condon hosted, Chris Carlin hosted a Yankee rally yesterday at Bryant Park.
You did?
The big Met fan.
I unfortunately did. I'm not even a Met fan, but you know I hate the Yankees, but I did host that rally.
How many people showed up for that?
About 2,000 people.
Oh, my God. These people all have the ability to vote.
Unbelievable.
Well, that's been procreated, probably.
Geez. You want a little taste of how that went? I got a little cut from it.
Yes.
Let's go, Yankee fans! The greatest fans in the world! Let's go, Yankees!
Get off the stage, you fat
f***!
Worked out well for you, huh?
Oh, it was a fun day.
Now I know I'm dirty, and I know I smoke a lot of dope. But it ain't like I'm going on TV and tearing out pictures of the Pope. I know I get wild and I know I get drunk, but it ain't like I've got a bunch of bodies in a chunk. Now a man used to call me a no-good punk, and I still don't know why. I think I'm an all right guy. I think I'm an all right guy. I think I'm all right. I'm all right.
Kind of in the morning.
It's here. The all-new 2007 Chrysler Sebring. And from the first look, it's sure to impress. The all-new Sebring comes completely redesigned with distinct, eye-catching styling. The vehicle's sleek athletic stance is highlighted with gorgeous chrome accents. And a raked hood that's understated yet extremely elegant. However, the all-new Sebring is substance as well as style. Take a seat behind the wheel, and you're in one of the most intelligent vehicles on the road. Want proof? Just switch on the available MyGig multimedia infotainment system. It has a 20-gigabyte hard drive for storing music. It's voice-activated and is USB and Bluetooth capable. Under the Sebring hood is the renowned 2.4-liter world engine that offers a fuel-efficient EPA estimated 32 miles per gallon highway. The new Chrysler Sebring is here, and it's available for a price that's also impressive. Starting at just $18,995, as described, $22,990. MSRP excludes tax.
Did I ever tell you my... official launch will go. It is 8 minutes past the hour.
17 minutes after the hour, and I am Hamas in the morning. Coming up, the Saddam Salutes Classic Country Giveaway. Your chance to be winning $1,000 dinar, a Saddam turban, and a bottle of Saddam Untamed Infidel Cologne. But first, Badi Jawal from Baghdad Star will be on in a little while. He has new album. Here is Little Taste. No. That is enough of that. That is troubling. I mean, please. Shaka, do some news.
Okay, H-Man. Top story this morning concerns transfer of power.
Due to sudden resignation of our leader, Vilecom Infidel Broadcasting President, Amal Karma Chameleon.
I mean transfer of power to restore full sovereignty to our country. Replacing interim Prime Minister Iyad Alawi with...
A man to whom I am most loyal.
Prime Minister Alawi?
No. Amal Karma Chameleon. He is also very loyal.
Yes.
He stuck by Chabad Stern.
Yes, indeed.
Okay, maybe he bailed out on Obladi and Altekriti, but now they're going to be found on secure channel of satellite communications. I am loving Obladi and Altekriti. Have I told you, Chaka? I have adopted Obladi.
Right.
Nice kid. Mm. Loves the H-Man. Ugh! This kefir is awful.
What's wrong?
How hard is it to make a fermented milk drink?
Oh,
I am not feeling well.
Here we go.
Bundy, play that wacky new song parody.
Have a little bitty brain full, a little bitty thought.
No. Enough. That is enough. That is just enough. 18 minutes after the hour, and I am Hamas in the morning on Kairaki Radio here in Tikrit and on Hamas NBC TV all over the country from 6 to 9 Middle Eastern time. Coming up, Badi Jawal.
Hamas in the morning.
Here I go again. Just get warmed up.
I'm going to be a leader for peace by strengthening our alliances. We will be friends with our allies when we don't eat each other.
Too many good docs are getting out of business. Too many OBGYNs aren't able to practice their love with women all across this country.
There's an old saying in Tennessee, I know it's in Texas, probably Tennessee, that says, fool me once.
Nuclear weapons. He's a tool, understood. He's got dick in a white hood. Katie's a bit out of touch. But Bobo's going down now, cause I'm voting W. Bush.
Under the dictator, prisons like Abu Ghraib, Abu Ghraib. And to the C students, you too can be president of the United States. God bless America.
Boy. I'm in the morning.
Now
thousands of people have doubled, tripled, even quadrupled their income. Not by working harder and not by working longer hours. Rather by working smart
sports. I'm Jerry Recco.
Ready?
Hello.
All right, no, can't hear. Okay, let's go. Ready?
I'm hearing everything.
All right, applause. Thank you very much.
Jesus.
Do all that echo in there? Okay. Thank you very much.
Can we turn him
down?
Oh,
damn it, Jeff. You don't even need a microphone. Just take them tickets. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Kinky.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're very welcome.
Many thanks.
Many thanks to you.
Don't put me up on a pedestal now.
I don't want to.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Many thanks.
So welcome to you, Kinky.
Mucus Garcia.
Same bad to you.
Thank you very much.
And me too.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Kinky.
No, damn it. Something's wrong with that, Jeff.
You're welcome, Kinky.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Kinky.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Many thanks.
You're so very,
thank you very,
so
much.
Very welcome.
Thank you, many
you're
thanks.
You're welcome, Kinky.
Been a wonderful crowd.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
No, thank you. You're welcome, Kinky.
All right. I hope they're...
Was anything recorded?
I'm listening
in the morning. Some cowboy hat.
Beautiful.
All right.
Is that something you might wear?
Oh, yes. I train barrel horses and gallop race horses.
Oh,
I'm ready for Smarty Jones to win tomorrow.
Who's going to run second?
Brock Hard.
All right.
There you go.
I'm going to get you a jug of untamed cologne. Are you married? Do you have a boyfriend?
Yes, sir. I'm married. My husband told me to call. He watches you faithfully every morning.
Yeah.
He laughs along with y'all.
Put some of that cologne on him.
Make him acceptable.
Get the stink off of him. And I'm sending you a Stetson Salutes Classic Country CD.
All right.
And I'm going to decide. I haven't figured out how I'm going to decide who gets to go to Nashville for the 38th Annual CMA Awards. We'll probably put all the names in a hat and pick a winner. And we'll do that later this morning, okay?
That sounds wonderful.
All right. How about we put all the names in Sid's pocket and we have Michelle try to fish it out?
Okay, just put mine on the top.
That's what we're going to do. All
okay.
Right, Christy, hang on. Do not hang up, Christy. We need to get your name and address, all right?
I will.
And then look for Bernard lurking outside your trailer. Hang on, baby.
Than Ahmed Manjahi, and well, he ought to keep his big mouth shut, though. Mouthing off about George Bush at the Olympics.
That'll be fine.
You know, he's lucky Uday Hussein ain't around anymore to run that Iraqi Olympic Committee. He'd have his feet chopped off.
15 minutes after the hour, and I am Hamas in the morning. On the phone is my brother Farid, who I am beginning to believe he's adopted.
This guy goes into a bar with a goat under his arm.
No. Here we go.
And he orders a beer, and he gives it to the goat, and the bartender says, "What are you doing?" And the guy says, "Be quiet. I'm trying to get my date drunk."
Get off my phone.
Yeah, assalamu alaikum.
How much in the morning?
Thank you.
credit for it more.
CBS Radio. All rights reserved. Imus in the Morning is a presentation of WFAN and Westwood One Entertainment. Streaming at WFAN.com and broadcasting in high definition. We're your flagship station for Imus in the Morning. Joe Beningo and Evan Roberts middays from 10 to 1. Mike and the Mad Dog in the afternoon. And New York sports all day. The Fan. Sports Radio 66. WFAN New York.
WFAN.
This is John Minko, Broncos cornerback.
2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for New York Giants football.
Steve Summers. Sports Radio 66. WFAN. Sports Radio
66. Well, a happy new year to you all at 6:07 and 25 seconds on this New Year's evening on your Fan New York City. Steve Summers here and you there, Sal Licata. Rick Bonacorsi, he's on the other side of the glass as well. 1-718-937-6666. That's the number for a New Year's evening schmooze, what? Right up until Mark Malusis. He's coming up at 9 on your Fan New York City. Right back to the phones we go. Marcus
Cole. WFAN 2020 Sports.
This is Joe Beningo.
I'm Evan Roberts. Join us every weekday from 10 to 1.
We'll be on right after Imus in the Morning and right before Mike and the Mad Dog.
On your flagship station for New York sports, The Fan.
Sports Radio 66 WFAN in New York.
6:23 in The Fan. Time to check traffic. It is the Geico Fan Highway Patrol with Jacqueline and Carl.
Hey, Bob, on the Hutch southbound at Cross County Parkway.
Snow might be great for White Mountain. It leaves a lot of drivers with white knuckles. Unless you're in a Subaru Outback. Like every Subaru, it has standard all-wheel drive, a Boxster engine with a lower center of gravity for stability, and an incredible safety record. And it gets the government's highest crash test rating. Quite simply, the Outback gives you the freedom you need to enjoy the season. And that's why, in my opinion, Subaru is the official car of New York. It's what makes a Subaru. To learn more, visit safercar.gov and Subaru.com. Now, get great deals during the Subaru all-wheel deal year end clearance. Hurry, you must take delivery to New York stops by January 2nd.
Hear that? It's the sound of progress in New York. Of schools, hospitals, corporate offices, and homes being built in every borough. It's the job engine that employs 150,000 construction professionals and skilled union trade workers. It's the pulse of New York's growing middle class and a thriving economy. It's the heartbeat of the BTEA Contractors Association.
Hi, I'm Lou Coletti, president of the BTEA Contractors Association, New York's largest association of union contractors. With over 1,200 members, the BTEA is the foremost authority on construction in New York. Our members have built every major structure in this city, and today they are responsible for over 80% of all new projects. Hear that? That's the sound of a BTA contractor's employee arriving home safely to his family, because our projects are 6 times safer than those built by anyone else. We set the industry standard for building skillfully, efficiently, and most of all, safely. BTEA Contractors Association. When it's built right, it's built by the BTEA.
5 minutes after the hour here on the Imus in the Morning program on the radio all over the country. And on MSNBC, Tom Brokaw's coming up this morning. I was pleased when I got down here to see that.
Yeah.
Because in all of the show preparation I did for this morning, it consisted of calling Randall, trying to get a hold of Dave, to see if Dave could come to the ranch to turn everything on.
Mr. Brokaw, who will deliver one of the tributes at the Ford funeral this morning.
I love Brokaw.
He's a great guy, great man.
You know, we have two photographs here. I'm still at the ranch because we got snowed in here.
Right.
When I say snowed in, I mean 4 feet of snow.
You mean not even open the front door snowed in.
Well, there must be some secret if you're locked in a house, in this case, a hacienda with people, and you can't get out. What is it that keeps you from killing them? Or them you, by the way.
Great reserves of patience, I man.
Of course, the satellite goes down. The internet goes down.
Right.
So there's no way to find out anything. Because you have no clue, you have no idea what's going on anywhere at any time about anything.
Marooned.
Yeah. Anyway, then Howard Feynman is coming up. And then I think MSNBC is going to take the program until, I don't know when, 8 or so Eastern time. But we're on the radios. They perhaps know.
Right.
With several million people listening.
Yes.
And then Douglas Brinkley, the historian, will be on. Today's a national day of mourning for Gerald Ford. He's still lying in state there in the Capitol, right, Charles?
Exactly. Aye, man. Until
what's the schedule of a...
The body lying in state will be moved to the doors of the Senate this morning to lie briefly in repose there. Short ceremony on the east steps of the Senate, and then it'll be transported to the Washington National Cathedral for the funeral, which is scheduled to begin at 10:30 this morning. Tributes, as we mentioned, delivered by President Bush, former President Bush, former Secretary of State Kissinger, and news anchor Tom Brokaw.
On New Year's Eve, I guess they had all those, like, rocking New Year's Eve stuff, and did you watch on him?
I did not, as a
did
matter
of fact. Did Chris watch on him?
Briefly.
Lou, did you watch on him?
Rockin' Eve, yes.
What was that, Dick Clark deal?
He was on.
Yeah.
How'd that go?
Unbelievable.
Dick Clark was on?
Yeah, he was on.
Wow.
And it wasn't just like, it's a little appearance, a tribute to Dick. He was a part of the program. Of course, it's his New Year's Rockin' Eve.
Right.
And he shared the stage with Ryan Seacrest, pretty much.
Hmm.
Really? You coming up in midnight?
Oh, my God.
It sounded really bad.
Oh, it's bad.
But he was there for the duration, you mean?
For
the Oh, wow.
He did the whole countdown.
But even with all that handicap, he wasn't as bad as Carson Daly was on NBC.
Right.
Yeah, that guy's terrible.
Well, who lets Dick Clark do that? And why'd they let him do that?
He's the boss. He's the man. Nobody can tell him.
His wife can't say, look, Dick, I mean, come on.
Apparently, unlike in some households, he wears the pants. And he calls the shots.
Oh, I see. Hmm. Well, there's your answer.
If he wants to make himself sound like he's drunk, actually.
Oh, God bless him. I hope he gets all right. But
he's not going out in style.
No. Oh. I guess, Well, I didn't hear any of that. Well, we don't need to play that, I guess. Roy Charles?
Well, unless you wanted
to miss a countdown.
Satisfy your curiosity just to see what it was like. It's tradition. It is Mr. Clark. And,
how did Chris Carlin's here this morning? How did we get to all the news? By the way, congratulations to Saddam Hussein. I mean, if you're going to be a murdering dictator and despot, and they hang you, don't wet your pants with wine. Which he didn't.
He did not.
You know, he's swearing at the guards.
Go to hell. Tell him to go to hell.
Tell him to go to hell.
Yeah. Kept his chin up.
Yeah.
Said, so, no thank you to the hood.
Right.
Being hooded and...
Is this the way gentlemen behave, he said?
Is this how
men show their bravery, he said?
Yeah, see, when I like James Cagney.
And the people were hanging them, they had the hoods on.
Yeah.
Well, good for him. Congratulations to, this happened some time ago, but Rutgers won their game, right, Chris?
They did last week, 37-10 over Kansas State. Beat them up pretty good in the Texas Bowl.
But Kansas State, I mean, that's who they had to play, right?
Yeah.
They weren't much of a team, were they?
Yeah, well, they had beaten Texas a few weeks ago. A pretty good team. Big 12, good opponent.
I was able to watch a little bit of Boise State, Oklahoma last night, even though Tom Brenneman, that's really tough to listen to him. But they started out the game by, how long can the little dogs hang with the big dogs? Meaning, how long could Boise State play with Oklahoma?
Right.
Apparently, quite a while.
Yes, evidently.
Apparently so.
Apparently they could play with them into overtime. Apparently they could beat them.
they could hang the whole game with them.
Exactly right. I actually shut it off when, I don't know how much time has left. It was deep into the fourth quarter, because there were 2 or 3 minutes left. Maybe not that much. And the guy from Boise State threw an interception. Well, first of all, Oklahoma tied it up 28-28.
Right.
Then the guy threw an interception from Boise State, and Oklahoma went ahead 34-28. Well, what happened then?
Well, Boise State got the ball back, and they got the ball, they got it out to about midfield. And with 18 seconds left, this kid Zabransky, the quarterback, throws a pass over the middle for 18 yards. Looks like they're going to be close to a first down. And it's called the hook and ladder play. So there was a lateral. The receiver caught it, lateraled it to another receiver, who bolted down the sideline 35 yards and scored a touchdown to tie the game. An unbelievable play. Unbelievable play.
Right.
And Oklahoma just looked lost on it. So they go to OT, and then Oklahoma scores first, takes a 42-35 lead. Boise comes back. On fourth down, they line up a receiver in the shotgun. He throws a touchdown pass, so they're down one, and they go for two to try to win it. Not to tie it, to go to another OT, like some kind of wuss team. They went for it, got it on like this kind of reverse handoff misdirection play, and they win 43-42. Unbelievable win.
Well, I mean, Oklahoma went into this thing saying, I mean, all of their supporters, everybody in the country saying you can't lose to Boise State, right?
Right. I mean, Boise was undefeated. They come from a non-BCS conference in the WAC. And, listen, they did an unbelievable job to win this game. They got out 14-0 on them early. Oklahoma didn't look like they were in great shape. Then they came back, and Boise just fought through it. It's a great story. It's an absolutely great story.
What happened in the Rose Bowl?
It wasn't good for Michigan. They weren't even in the game for most of the night. They lost 32-18 to SC.
Wasn't even that close.
Yeah,
Booty was hot.
Yeah, he was. Four touchdown passes.
Right.
And Dwayne Jarrett, 205 yards receiving. A tremendous day for USC.
Just a shame,
What are you saying?
What?
What? Go ahead.
It's just a shame.
Go ahead, say it.
There's nothing to say.
Well, clearly you're alluding to something.
No, but... right before Ohio State, poor old Bo Schembechler dies mysteriously.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Suddenly?
Suddenly. If somebody pops out of a mop closet at the TV station and scares Bo well to death.
Oh, my.
Hey, brother. And then we're coming up on the Rose Bowl, and...
And what?
Their most famous football alum... 38th president of the United States, a
superstar while there.
Well,
a little special pocket of hell for you, my friend. That's what there's going to be.
Oh, yeah.
Like there's regular hell, and then there's your little corner.
What are you talking about?
For you to suggest that this is even, for you to suggest what I think you're suggesting.
I'm not suggesting anything. I'm just talking. I'm relating the facts to you.
Man, you got to connect the dots there, Porky. Come on.
You can be blind to the facts if you want, but that's...
Put it together.
Oh, my God. I just can't help it because you can't see what's going on.
You're unbelievable.
Quarter after the hour here in the Amherst Morning Program.
Sad.
Very. Is this guy out of rehab yet, Lou, Keith Urban?
Yeah, he's got other problems, I think, as well.
This is a great record. So.
I can see it in your eyes and feel it in your touch. I know that you're scared, but you've never been this loved. It's a long shot, baby, I know it's true. But if anyone can make it, I'm betting on me and you. Keep on moving into me.
Tanya Robertson, guess what? The New Year is here, and it's time for you and that special person to start making those pesky resolutions. What are you going to be doing? Lose weight, stop smoking, clean out your closet. Well, I have a resolution idea that I know you can keep. Spend 3 days and two nights at a Las Vegas resort and don't pay a dime for it. It's all part of the grand opening of Las Vegas' newest five-star resort, Tahiti Village. Start off the new year right. Recharge those romantic batteries with a fantastic second honeymoon package. Call now and we'll also throw in tickets to a hot show right on the strip. To receive the high roller treatment and your complimentary second honeymoon, call 877-57-GO-NOW. That's 877-57-GO-NOW for the time of your life. 877-57-GO-NOW. Call now.
Imus.
Challenge. Donald Trump is searching the nation for people who want to be millionaires, people who want to succeed in life and become something better. If that's you, this is your chance. Donald Trump wants to show you how to make money, have fun, and get started on the successful life you've always imagined.
I think we've come up with something that is going to be spectacular.
Donald Trump is now offering to the public his Wealth Builder's Blueprint System, a proven system that reveals his secrets to generating incredible wealth. And because he believes in the power of this blueprint, he wants to send you a free tape to help you get started today. Just call 1-800-400-8407.
You have to love it. You have to really want it, and you have to love what you're doing.
This blueprint is only for people who want to succeed in life, who want to become millionaires and have fun doing it. This is your chance. Call now for Donald Trump's powerful free tape. Call 1-800-400-8407. That's 1-800-400-8407.
Blast off into the new year with a new set of wheels! Right now,
January 7th. In Queens, westbound on the LIE, it is slow in between Vanwick and Woodhaven Boulevard. Over New Jersey, Pulaski Skyway, Route 1 and 9, inbound after Kearney, there's an accident blocking the right lane. Out on Long Island, Southern State Parkway, fairly clear in between exit 43A for Carlton Avenue and the Cross Island Parkway. And on the LIE westbound, it's good in between Route 112 and Deer Park Avenue. Hudson River Crossing's looking good. East River Crossing's looking good. Parking rules back in effect today. The Imus in the morning forecast, mostly sunny skies, but windy. High temperatures near 50 degrees. It's currently 46 degrees under clear skies in Central Park. I'm Bob with the Geico Fan Highway Patrol.
It is 21 after the hour here in the Imus in the morning program on the radio all over the country.
Then on MSNBC, Tom Brokaw's coming up. Then Howard Feynman. Later on this morning, we'll talk with Douglas Brinkley. Tomorrow, Reverend Jerry Falwell will be in, and so will Bill Clinton. But today, a national day of mourning for Gerald Ford. And not much not to like about him.
Absolutely.
Like nothing not to like about him.
Right.
Always liked him. I guess I didn't realize he was as great an athlete as he was.
I didn't know the full parameters of it.
No.
He was something.
I mean, he didn't just, you know, play football like Nixon did at Whittier College or whatever it was. I mean, he was, you know, star of the team.
Yeah.
Anyway, before we get to a bunch of other stuff, let's go to Richard Engel, NBC News in Baghdad. Good morning, Richard.
Good morning, Don. Welcome back for your vacation. While you were away, a major, major story developing here that happened, the execution, of course, of Saddam Hussein, and it is not over. It did not bring closure to the Iraqis. Instead, the very chaotic scene of Saddam's execution while he was standing there on the gallows being taunted by his guards has opened up a lot of old wounds and exposed the sectarian conflict in this country. The guards were shouting out the name of at least one of them, a Shiite militant cleric while Saddam was about to be executed, and it has created a public relations disaster for the Iraqi government and for the U.S. administration, calling into question the entire legal process that tried and ultimately executed Saddam Hussein, painting it in a very sectarian light.
How did this video get out, Richard, do you know?
It was taken by one of the witnesses. The Iraqi government says it is now investigating exactly how the video was released. It was taken on a cell phone, and then it was about a 2.5-minute video, and then it's been distributed like wildfire here in Iraq. Everyone has been passing it along on the internet or using their cell phones. I would say the majority of Iraqis by now have seen this, but not only here in Iraq, it is all spread throughout the Arab world. So I've spoken with people in Jordan and Egypt. They have all seen this video.
You know, you do have to kind of hand it to Saddam. I mean, as long as you're going to be, you know, a murdering despot responsible for the deaths of millions of people, at least when he was hanged, well, he didn't wet his pants and whine about it. He just said, you know, put the rope on, let's get it on. So.
Very much, and that's part of the image that the Iraqi government is trying to confront. Saddam Hussein, in the end, according to all accounts, looked very dignified, very brave, and it was the state executioners that ended up looking like something of a lynch mob. And that is not the PR message that the U.S. administration or the Iraqi government wanted to project.
And then the New York Times is reporting, Richard, as you perhaps know, that the United States tried to get Maliki to delay the hanging, but obviously to no avail. What do you know about that?
I've spoken with Iraqi officials who've confirmed the same thing, that U.S. officials were not pleased that after a very lengthy trial, Saddam's appeal was rushed through. It only took several weeks to complete the appeal process. And then it seemed that the Iraqi government was in high gear. They wanted this execution to be carried out right away, and the American administration were pushing for some legal complications to be more completely ironed out. In the end, they never satisfied everyone in this country that all of the legal procedures were in place to hang Saddam Hussein. And it would have been preferable, Americans say, for it to be taken place after the Eid holiday. There's a Muslim holiday underway right now, raising other sensitivities here. It offended the many Sunnis in this country and across the Arab world that the execution took place at this timing. So, yes, American officials were not pleased with this, but when they saw the Iraqi government was so insistent, ultimately said, this is an Iraqi process, you're going to have to exert your authority.
So the bottom line then, talking with Richard Engel, NBC News in Baghdad, the bottom line then is that it's just made things worse, right? If that's possible.
It has quickly emerged as one of the iconic images of the war. Since it began in 2003, there have been a few images. Shock and awe, Abu Ghraib, the toppling of the Saddam statue, and now Saddam Hussein on the gallows is going to remain forever burned in the minds of Iraqis and people who've been watching this war around the world. And unfortunately, or from the U.S. and Iraqi perspective, this final moment is only going to strengthen Saddam's image and create him as something of a martyr.
Unbelievable. Take care.
care of yourself, Richard, and Happy New Year. Richard Engel, NBC News in Baghdad.
God.
You can't make it up, can you?
No, you can't.
And you hear what that new breeze says. And no drag. Papa's got a brand new bag.
Marching with the penguins in Antarctica, the white continent, with its unmatched natural beauty, remains a world apart. A majestic frontier of walruses, whales, seals, and of course, vast colonies of penguins. Elegant Cruises explores this fragile world in complete comfort and elegant style aboard its deluxe...
You to say to me that there's my own little corner of hell for me, but all I have done regarding this whole University of Michigan thing is just relay the facts of what happened. Just look at the facts. That's all I'm saying. They go into a big game against Ohio State, and Bo Schembechler mysteriously dies.
Oh, who?
Schembechler. Well, what did I say?
You sound like Mr. Brokaw.
Well, saying, whatever. You know what I mean.
You're all out.
Well, you know who I mean.
Bo Fish Tickler.
Sound like Dick Clark. Poor thing.
Bless him.
Well, that's way out there.
And then the next thing you know, we're getting ready to play SC. And, you know, Michigan thinks they should be playing Ohio State for the national... Well, they don't think that now.
No.
And God bless him, poor President Jerry Ford dies. They're in Palm Springs. And well, he was the most famous Michigan alum ever. And a genuine star of the football team. And they had a little sticker on the helmet, Bo and 48. I mean, just...
Huh? Remarkable coincidence or conspiracy?
Yes. So I don't, you know, I my email started working again yesterday, and I brought this up with Lupica, and he thought it was just idiotic that I would make this suggestion, but then... You know, why would Lupica be concerned when we all know what his dad does for a living, running the whole organized crime situation there in the Northeast, up out of Rhode Island, or where the hell it is. Well, anyway, here's Chris.
Well, I immediately regretted it when I said that you're going to have your own special corner of hell. That was about 2.5 minutes ago, and about 30 seconds ago, I took that regret back. I'm missing your exact implication here, or... How you're so-called connecting the dots, as you say. What? Maybe I'm just not bright enough to put them all together. What exactly are the dots connecting here?
I don't know. That would be up to you to try to figure out. So.
Are you saying that they were looking for some extra inspiration for the football team? Is that what you're trying to say?
They had the sticker on the helmet.
We report, you decide.
Yeah. They had the sticker on the helmet, Bowl 48. I mean, hello?
Well, don't put the I-Man on the stand. He's just...
Yes.
Put, he just put,
I'm just... Thank you, Bernard.
He's not the he's perpetrator. No, he's
simply a grand juror.
He's an investigator.
That's all.
Messenger.
Well, just asking the questions here.
I decide that's moronic.
Okay, that's fine.
Sports is sponsored by Peerless Boilers. Go to peerlessboilers.com for a dealer near you.
The cover-up is sponsored by whatever.
What cover-up?
Well, okay, good. Go ahead.
Oh, just the knowing of, okay, if you choose to have your eyes closed, fat boy, that's up to you.
No, I wasn't going
to
say
that. Kind
of
sounds to me like what you're saying.
I wasn't going to say something mean like fat boy. So,
at least at the moment.
Yeah.
Anyway, it was Southern California with a 32-18 win over Michigan.
Yeah. Really?
In the Rose Bowl, yes. It was a big day for John David Booty, 4 touchdown passes, nearly 400 yards passing. Terrific day for him.
Booty was moving nice.
Booty was rolling.
Yeah.
Playing very well. And last night in the Fiesta Bowl, an incredible win for Boise State as they took care of Oklahoma in overtime, 43-42. They scored a touchdown with just 7 seconds left, and then scored a touchdown in overtime and went for 2 to win it and got it. So Boise State comes away with an unexpected victory and to cap off their 13-0 regular season. Folks in Idaho should be very proud of that young group of young men.
I just saw that lateral on
Incredible.
MSNBC, what the hell is going to put
in? Isn't that unbelievable?
Play, yeah.
Unbelievable. And if you're, you know, I mean, it's just the way they did it. Oklahoma just looked completely lost on some of these plays at the end of the game. And as a result, Boise comes away with the victory.
Go State.
Exactly right. God bless the state of Idaho.
Potatoes for everyone.
Ian Johnson, who scored on the two-point conversion, actually went and proposed to his girlfriend, one of the cheerleaders, after the game. Very exciting moment for he and his girlfriend, Chrissy Papadix, who was apparently shocked by the press.
That's not the name.
That is
not
the name.
Wait, come on,
man.
Come on.
Joe Papadix.
If you're sick and tired of watching your hair get thinner and thinner, we're about to challenge everything you think you know about hair loss and hair restoration.
They put a graphic up that says, "Where's Obama?"
Problem.
And so I asked Charles, I said, I've only typed about 50 million words in my life, but I couldn't remember where the B and the S were on the keyboard, but they're on different lines even.
Yes.
And
B on the bottom, S in the middle. And
yeah, so it wasn't one of those deals where I do it all the time where I hit the wrong thing. You know?
Right, right. That's surprising, seeing as how most of what you type is probably BS.
31 FDR, please welcome to the Amherst Morning Program. The editor from Newsweek Magazine, John Meacham. Good morning, Mr. Meacham.
He has to choose whether or not he's going to stay in college or go pro. Here's Jamarcus after the game.
I have a lot of time to go home and have a big time this season, mate. Just pray about the situation whenever I'm ready to decide, you know, deal, then that's that.
Young man with a bright future ahead of him.
Well, where would his future otherwise be?
What's his major?
You know, I don't know off the top of my head. I'm not, I don't remember exactly.
Oh, it would be academia's loss.
What, his future would not be behind him, would it?
No.
Well, then why would you say he has a bright future ahead of him?
I've heard a lot of people say that. Why are you nitpicking on him?
No, no.
Are you nitpicking on me?
Yes, why do you say it? It's idiotic.
Yeah. What did you major in?
It's redundant. His future is, it's implied.
I think you're nitpicking.
His future is, no, I'm not nitpicking. You sound like a moron. I'm trying to help you. So
clearly.
He has a bright future. He doesn't have a bright future behind him, does he?
No, he doesn't.
Okay, then why do you say he has a bright future ahead of him?
It was just a manner of speaking.
Well, it's the wrong, don't say
wrong.
It anymore. Stop saying it.
Ignorant.
It's like people say general consensus. A consensus is general. You don't, that's a redundant.
Happy New Year.
No, I mean, do you want me to help you or not?
Happy feet.
You're the guy getting married at the pizza joint, not me.
Yeah. You just asked if I want you to help me. Do I want you to help me or
yes.
not? No, I don't want you to
okay.
help me.
Stop saying. As Frank Gifford used to say that. There's a bright future ahead of me. Well, yes, Frank. Where else would it be? That's my point. Where else would his future be?
Can we go back to the Nardelli thing for a few minutes?
Yes.
No future ahead of
him. By the way, are you getting excited?
Beyond excited. I'm 3 weeks away from getting married.
23 days, baby.
How great is this?
It is good.
It's going to be a lot of fun. So I'm looking forward to it. It's going
to
be great.
We're not going to be able to make it. We have to go to San Antonio.
You do?
No.
Well, it's disappointing.
What?
I know a lot of my relatives were looking forward to meeting you.
Oh, brother.
You know, my Aunt Billy in particular from Bay Ridge, she's a huge fan of yours. I'm not kidding. She watches you and listens every day.
That's great.
So I was going to put you at her table, but that's...
Here's what you do. You see Julie.
Yeah.
Get one of those PR photos of me.
Get the cutout.
Get the cutout. Get the cutout.
Get the cutout.
The standard next to the life-size cutout.
I think the more entertaining thing would be to bring the cutout back after the ceremony, don't you?
And show hey, clean it off first.
We're talking with Chris Carlin doing sports here in the Imus Morning Program, 28 after the hour. Craig Crawford, John McCain, and Denise Austin coming up. Did Nick Saban, what's his name?
Nick Saban, yeah.
Did he lie about it? What's the deal?
Well, he said that...
He left the Miami Dolphins to coach Alabama, right?
He said during the season, exactly right, that he was not going to be Alabama's coach. And over the last couple of days, they had a little change of heart, did some hard thinking, and found out they were going to give him $32 million guaranteed.
Right.
So he was headed to Alabama. So I don't know if you could say he lied. Is it lied or is it changed his mind? It's semantics. He said during the season that he wasn't going to do it. But I think he got his mind changed when Alabama came at him even harder with more money.
Is that good?
He's a very good coach.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he's a very good. He did a great job at Michigan State, won a national championship at LSU a few years back. He hasn't had a lot of luck his 2 years in the pros, but he'll do a good job for Alabama.
Oh, he will.
He absolutely will do a good job for Alabama.
Better than he did at Miami.
Yes, absolutely. I get the feeling he might be more of a college coach than a pro coach.
He's got a great future ahead of him at Alabama.
He does have a bright, bright future ahead of him in Tuscaloosa.
Now, how about Charlie Weiss at Notre Dame? Is he? What's he doing?
Well, I think he's staying. He keeps saying that he's staying. But, you know, will the Giants job come open? I think that depends on what happens this weekend. If it's open, I would think they would look hard at him and see if they could get him because he's great with quarterbacks and Eli Manning clearly needs some tutoring. So I think that it all depends on what happens in Philadelphia on Sunday. I think Tom Coughlin's getting a bad rap here. Good guy.
Well,
what?
But here we go.
What?
You're an apologist.
I mean, this
is outrageous. Don't you do the Giants pregame or postgame or some kind of show? Aren't you,
I do.
Don't you work for them or something?
I don't work for the Giants. I work for WFAN here in New York.
Well, doesn't WFAN, that's a sports radio station,
yes,
is it?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Don't they, that station, which we happen to be on, by the way, don't they have some deal with the Giants?
Well, they carry the games, and I do the pre- and post-game.
Uh-huh.
Yep. With Carl Banks.
And then don't they have a situation where they actually pay the coach, Coughlin, to appear with Mike and Chris?
Yeah, sure. But that has nothing to do with my opinion.
No. Bingo.
Why would it?
You're Jack sniffing sycophants.
Yeah, thank you, Lord, very much. Is that a number?
Jackpot is up to $102 million. That's a big $102 million. Play New Jersey's Mega Millions today and give your dreams a chance.
20 years from now, women are infertile. No children, no future, no hope. But all that can change.
She's pregnant.
In a heartbeat.
They want your baby. We have to leave.
The Los Angeles Times raves, Children of Men is Blade Runner for the 21st century. Newsweek calls it dazzling, a gripping thriller. Director Alfonso Cuarón stages breathtaking action sequences unlike anything you've seen. The New York Times says, the action is swift, ferocious, spectacularly photographed. Children of Men transports you with the greatness of its filmmaking. And Rolling Stone hails, it's spellbinding. Alfonso Cuarón has a gift only the greatest filmmakers share. He makes you believe. It grabs you hard, provokes your mind, and ultimately lifts your spirits. Clive Owen, Julianne Moore, Michael Caine, directed by Alfonso Cuarón. Children of Men, rated R, under 17, not admitted without parents. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
5 minutes after the hour here in the Imus in the Morning program. Well, we're going to dig up this Keith Olbermann stuff from last night, in which Keith, of course, has a competent staff. But then Bernard points out that we don't have anybody on our staff who's assigned to this. I don't know what they're assigned to do, but it's just a source of constant irritation. But we're going to assign somebody. That's going to be their job to find out these kinds of things. As soon as I can get Olbermann's deal, this is good. He's got this deal where he does the worst, worser, and worst.
Right.
So, apparently McCain was the worst person in the world last night.
Uh-oh.
But O'Reilly was right in there, too. It's just funny stuff. So. And apparently accurate. How are you, Charles? You look nice today.
Thank you.
Trump will be on today. I like Trump. Maybe the show, so the Apprentice thing starts, when, Sunday night?
Oh, yeah. I guess.
Yeah, Sunday night. Yeah. What time Sunday night?
9:30, big 90-minute debut. 9:30 to 11.
Against Desperate Housewives?
Against the second half of Desperate Housewives.
It's going to be tough, isn't it?
Yep.
Then Andrea Mitchell's going to be out. Her book's out in paperback.
Oh.
So, the address here? Just a, I don't know. What? Well, a couple things, and then she and I are going to the, we have to leave from here to go to Michael Morgan's funeral.
Oh, that's right, I forgot.
Which is a sweet kid who died on New Year's Day.
Yeah.
So it's a ranch twice. Turned 17 on Christmas Day. And his funeral is in, well, it's near Philadelphia. Mm-hmm. So Brandt has to figure out how to... The funeral's not until next week. That's what we're... No, it's this morning, but... So I'm going to leave a little early this morning, which I'm sure you understand. And then Adriano Moraes is going to be here. He's a world champion bull rider, current world champion bull rider. And the big bull riding thing's at Madison Square Garden on Friday and Saturday.
In New York?
All right. You know who called me and wanted tickets? Robert Andrews.
Did he really?
Oh, he's the biggest yuppie on the planet.
Honest,
there's nobody more yuppie-fied than Robert Andrews. So he's going, Susie's going, and one of his sons and some babe that his sons managed to coerce into taking the bull riding thing. It's a lot of fun. I mean, it's in the bull riding. I'm not really into bull riding, but
fun to watch.
Yeah, I'm more into the other rodeo stuff, you know, team roping, tie-down roping, stuff like that. I like a little bronc riding once in a while, but I just don't get the point of riding these bulls, except you can make a lot of money doing it, but...
At some risk.
It's very difficult to do.
It appears to be. Good grief.
Chris Collins here. Randy Johnson is going back to the Diamondbacks. Good riddance. What a jerk. Just came to New York with an attitude. He's just
sour,
a big, stupid...
An instant attitude.
Yeah, just
like the biggest trailer trash jackass in the world.
Really?
Like he puts crystal meth on his cornflakes in the morning.
Baseball's answer to Britney Spears. You know?
At least he got the job done, though.
Yeah, in a postseason at an ERA of about 90. He's just a big, stupid jerk. Get out. So that's good. But Charles has some news.
That's it.
That was Nancy Pelosi yesterday. She was pretty good, wasn't she?
Yes, she was.
She certainly was.
She's clean. She looked nice.
She did look nice. Yeah. I don't know how many she was wearing. That was a good-looking suit.
Her teeth didn't fall out?
No. Yeah. None of that. Not all the grandkids up there with her? Good for her. It was about a half a commie, but I mean, what are you going to do? Maybe she'll lighten up a little. But I guess it was good. I don't know.
She's a good-looking older woman.
Well,
she looks like she was poseable right around, say, the Carter administration.
Have you seen the new Verizon commercial in which the guy comes out and he's talking to his two kids? It's obviously Christmas morning. And he says, what did you get? He says, well, you got the new chocolate phone. He says, the kid, you got the new something. He says, what did Dad get? Dad got hosed.
Dad got hosed.
You know where the term hosed originated?
Where would that be, I mean?
Pinky Friedman.
No
kidding. It's been 20 years ago, 25 years ago, but it's now become
part of
the vernacular of advertising. The
national lexicon.
And acceptable.
Yep.
Hosed. That was, but that was something Pinky Friedman came up
good
with.
Good Lord.
Well, what's going on in the world we need to know about?
Mrs. Pelosi, as the 110th Congress convened, and she accepted the Speaker's gavel, said one of the key reasons the Democrats are in charge now is the country's dissatisfaction with the obvious, the war in Iraq.
It is the responsibility of the president to articulate a new plan for Iraq that makes it clear to the Iraqis that they must defend their own streets and their own security.
House got down to business quickly, approving new ethics rules.
That'd be crazy, your grandma.
Changes in the types of paid trips members may accept.
What's this now?
And greater disclosure, new ethics rules, greater disclosure about the content of pet projects that they put into legislation. And House lawmakers today will debate legislation that would make it more difficult to increase federal benefit programs, would also threaten efforts to extend President Bush's tax cuts. The president, meantime, finalizing his new Iraq strategy, which he will unveil to the country next week, expected to contain political, military, and economic changes. General John Abizade, top U.S. commander in the Mideast, and General George Casey, chief general in Iraq, both expected to leave their jobs in the approaching weeks.
That's how they've done. I'll get the Medal of Freedom or whatever. whatever it is Bush gives all these people.
Yeah.
They could get that creep Tommy Franks. So, jug your loser. Go around humping that stupid book he is, which I'm pleased to point out that we did not support or promote. So.
Let Sammy get away.
Exactly. Well, what's going on in sports, Chris?
Well, you mentioned Randy Johnson is on his way out of New York. That's number one. He's going to get traded back to the Diamondbacks, a deal that will get announced early next week in exchange for right-handed reliever Luis Vizcaíno and three minor leaguers.
Is that an awning you have on?
An awning?
What is that?
This is a lovely shirt. What's your problem with this shirt?
Took it from John's Pizzeria.
Somebody throws
on like an old Howard Johnson's awning, doesn't it, John?
It does. Awning material.
What the hell is that?
Not awning. Anytime a big guy throws on color, it's going to draw a little attention to him.
Well, maybe we ought to think about that.
Looks like you just yanked it off a bar in Key West.
Yeah. I'm expecting to see Jimmy Buffett walk out in a minute.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Yeah.
So Johnson has 72 hours to work out an extension.
Hey, Lou, do you have that Jimmy Buffett Bama Breeze?
Yes, I have that.
I love that record.
Okay, hang on.
I also love Jimmy Buffett, by the way, but anyway, go ahead.
Bill Cowher expected to step down today as Steelers head coach after 15 seasons.
You know, that's what? Solid slobbering on his chin. That's always attractive.
Well,
like me at the hat shop there in Albuquerque.
Oh, my God. Don't relive that.
No, please. Nick Saban introduced yesterday as Alabama's new head coach. He says that education for his players just as important as football.
I always tell players in recruiting, there's two things that we want you to do here. You got two careers, one on the field and one off the field.
Sure.
And the one on the field means you got to graduate from college, and that's the one that's going to have the greatest impact on the quality of your life forever.
Everybody who believes that, stand on your head. Good luck with that, my friend. And you know what today is? Actually, you know what? By the way, we have some details on the Jim Lampley story from yesterday.
Oh, we do? Well, yeah. Now, what was the story? What was the original story?
Well, the story was that he was arrested on suspicion of domestic violence and also dissuading a witness.
Right.
So here it is. The woman who filed the domestic violence complaint claimed that he repeatedly threw her against the wall of her apartment after drinking heavily and smoking pot. That's according to TMZ.com. Candace Sanders claims on New Year's Eve, Lampley and his son Aaron joined her for dinner. Sanders says she was engaged to Lampley, who she claimed lived there, and she said after dinner at their apartment, Lampley was, quote, drinking vodka and whiskey and became drunk. She adds in the document that he was also high on pot when the incident occurred.
Right.
So we'll see where this goes for Mr. Lampley.
High African-American woman. Did she used to work for Trump?
I think she was former Miss California, something along those lines, wasn't she?
Yeah, exactly.
So,
well, what was the sun do? They were double-teaming her? What was going on?
I think that's unfortunate that you would say that or even allege that.
Well, what was going on?
They just said they were having dinner.
At the girl's apartment?
Yeah, for on New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah, okay.
Turn the lights down.
Yeah, that's fine.
And finally, it's Friday, so you ready for your first New Year's edition of You Know What? How about it?
The Fat Boy Lock of the Week.
Cowboys are in Seattle tomorrow night, and I love Dallas in this game as much as pepperoni pizza. The Cowboys will roll.
The Fat Boy Lock of the Week.
Cowboys are not going to roll, by the way.
There's Buffett. At the Bama Breeze, you can shoot some pool down there. You can act a fool down there. You can play it cool down there. At the Bama Breeze, you can drink some beer down there. Oh, you laugh and cheer down there. Half another year down there. Jimmy got caught smoking a joint out behind the bar. Sitting in his car and they took him to jail. Down there.
pioneered noise-reducing headphones now offers you a choice. New Quiet Comfort 3 acoustic noise-canceling headphones for a smaller on-ear design, or Quiet Comfort 2 headphones for an around-ear fit. Each offers the unmatched combination of noise reduction, audio performance, and comfortable fit that you expect from Bose. Call 800-485-2475 to try them for 30 days risk-free. Ask about low monthly payments with no interest charges from Bose. Enjoy them even more with a free MP3 player, a $50 value when you order by January 31st. 800-485-2475.
This is Rocky Moselle with International Star Registry. Give someone special to you the gift that will be remembered for years to come. Name a star after them. The Star Registry will name a star after anyone on your gift list for $54 and a call to 800-282-3333 or visit starregistry.com. It's the perfect gift for birthdays, weddings, and just about any occasion. Give the ultimate gift. Call the Star Registry at 800-282-3333 or visit starregistry.com. We proudly support the Starlight Starbright Children's Foundation.
Imus!
Have you dreamed of marching with the penguins in Antarctica? The white continent, with its unmatched natural beauty, remains a world apart. A majestic frontier of walruses, whales, seals, and of course, vast colonies of penguins. Elegant Cruises explores this fragile world in complete comfort and elegant style aboard its deluxe expedition ship, MS Andrea. Let Elegant Cruises' experienced team of naturalists and guides lead you through Antarctica in an environmentally responsible manner, leaving no mark other than your footprint. Elegant Cruises will pamper you with friendly, professional service, delectable cuisine, and deluxe accommodations while you collect memories that last a lifetime. For a free brochure, call your travel agent or Elegant Cruises at 800-683-6767 or visit elegantcruises.com. Call now and experience Antarctica in elegant style.
When you get nauseous, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea.
When you need relief from over-the-top symptoms, you need Pepto Max. It has twice the strength. So when you've overdone it, reach for Pepto Max. It's maximum pain. Go to PeptoBismolMax.com to tell your Max story.
If you wear black, even a little dandruff shows. And sometimes ordinary dandruff shampoo just doesn't do enough. That's why every day more and more people are switching from ordinary dandruff shampoos to Selsun Blue. Selsun Blue is doctor recommended for flakes and itch. Plus, there's added aloe and moisturizers to give you healthier hair and scalp. If you wear black, don't take a chance with ordinary dandruff shampoos. Do what so many people are doing every day. Make the switch to Selsun Blue. Never wear black without the blue. Selsun Blue.
ShopRite Executive Turkey Breast and your ShopRite Deli have let the word out. There's a super party planned at your home on Sunday, February 4th, today at the big game in Miami. When your friends hear about your new Sharp Aquas 37-inch high-definition liquid crystal television, they'll be arriving early. This party can happen if you enter ShopRite's big game six stakes. You'll have the opportunity to win the Sharp Aquas Full HD 1080p 37-inch liquid crystal TV. Nothing is lost on the Sharp Aquas with breathtaking color, incredible image clarity, and more lifelike detail. Plus, a fabulous lunch buffet courtesy of ShopRite. Three other lucky winners will each receive a Sharp 20-inch flat-screen liquid crystal television. Look for details in the ShopRite deli. And while you're there, ask for ShopRite Executive Turkey Breast. Each ShopRite Executive Turkey Breast is carefully handcrafted and then slowly pan-roasted or hickory-smoked to culinary perfection. At a time when consumers demand quality, ShopRite Executive Turkey Breast are the perfect choice to serve as the main course of a gourmet meal or as the highlight of a mouth-watering sandwich. Entry deadline is 1/21/06. No purchase necessary. ShopRite, always fresh, always for less.
Geico Fan Highway Patrol, brought to you by Welch's Purple Grape Juice. The American Heart Association recommends a diet rich in antioxidants. So, where can you find them? Welch's 100% Grape Juice is full of natural protective antioxidants. Problems out on Long Island, Northern State Parkway westbound between Route 110 and Round Swamp Road. There's a one-car accident on the shoulder. State troopers are on the scene. And on the LIE in Plainview, in between 110 and Sunnyside Boulevard, we have a tractor-trailer truck being pushed over to the right shoulder. In New Jersey, 109 northbound before Siles Avenue, there's an accident being cleared. It's in the parking lot, and all lanes are open. It's in Union County and Sayreville Garden State Parkway. Looking pretty good in between the Driscoll Bridge and the Union Toll Plaza. Street cleaning rules are in effect today. The Imus in the morning forecast. Some clouds, maybe some showers, but we could hit a record high, 63 degrees, and looking towards 70 degrees in the city tomorrow. I'm Bob with the Geico Fan Highway Patrol.
21 after the hour here in the Imus morning program on the radio all over the country and on MSNBC. Donald Trump's coming up. We'll talk to him about
Well, they taped this apprentice. Cause I remember when he went to L.A., didn't they do it last summer?
Yeah, yeah, quite a while ago.
So, but there's always other interesting things to talk to him about, like the Nardelli deal. And I finally got the chance to read all that stuff. And,
yeah.
And extensive coverage in the New York Times and
Wall Street Journal.
I didn't read all of the Wall Street Journal, although I actually read the Wall Street Journal stuff, but the Times seemed to have a better account of just what an arrogant skunk Nardelli was.
Man.
So.
He's,
You know, I know we have sort of a relationship with him, although occasionally I get irritated with him. But, you know, one of the best executives ever is Bob Wright, in terms of being able to get along with people.
Well, the way
everybody's smart, but
well, yeah,
obviously
but
smart.
But good skills in that other area.
Great skills.
Yes, sir.
He's a lovely guy.
Yeah.
So, same with Carmazan.
And it just the way they could.
People love Carmazan. I love Carmazan. You know, I mean, he's just, you didn't get much better than him, do you?
Mm-mm.
Fortunate he's ending his career, or if he is ending his career on a sort of sour note, dragging a bunch of us down, having us underwater with that serious stock. I can't breathe anyway, and I'm underwater with the stock.
Double oxygen over here, please.
Yeah. So, McCain was on this program yesterday. And I guess it was all over MSNBC yesterday, saying essentially, I have to paraphrase this, but that he was, he felt sorry for, or he that people were naive who thought that this Iraq thing was going to be easy. And he said that to me yesterday. Well, you know, we don't do any research on this program, so we're woefully ill-prepared to interview anybody. And most of the decent questions come from either Charles or mostly Bernard, or occasionally I'll think of something. But then other than that, it's just... Well, I stopped chewing the gum, so now I can't even pull the gum out of my mouth anymore. So, but Oberman's staff actually does some work. So, and they have their facts together. Now, of course, they have all day to do it, but that's fine. At least they get it done. So here's a little bit of Oberman from last night on MSNBC.
The Senator John McCain of Arizona told us today that he knew that the war in Iraq was, quote, probably going to be long and hard and tough, and that he was sorry for anybody who voted for it that thought it would be some kind of an easy task. Senator McCain on CNN, September 24th, 2002. I believe that the success will be fairly easy. Senator McCain on CNN on September 29th, 2002. We're not going to have a bloodletting of trading American bodies for Iraqi bodies. Senator McCain on this network on January 22nd, 2003. We will win this conflict. We will win it easily.
What's that called again?
Flip-flopping? Senator, we keep all the tapes of these interviews. Come on! Senator John McCain of Arizona, both of him, today's worst persons in the world.
Hey, do you have the O'Reilly stuff? Why can't we get something from our own network? Jesus, God, you're talking about, I mean, it's just unbelievable. Well, I get a call from Phil Griffin yesterday. He wants to have lunch or coffee or something. No, we're not having lunch or coffee, Phil. Jesus, I don't have time to have lunch. I mean, I'm not lying. This is a guy I like. But no, we're not going to go and do have lunch anywhere.
He's a lovely guy.
He is a lovely guy, but I mean, no. No, we're not having anything. Jesus, lunch? Who has time to have lunch? I mean, the inclination. I've had lunch once in about the last 20 years with Katzenberg over, wherever we went, Michael's, whatever it is, some dump that Lobster talked me into going to. It was not a dump. It's actually a fairly nice place.
Maybe he had some extra polonium hanging around.
So what is McCain talking about then? Did he forget he said that?
Well, he would argue that he meant the that we had too few troops. He meant the initial war of overthrowing Saddam. That's what he would argue. That's what he would say, and that went well. And then it was the aftermath that...
Ill-planned,
and the execution and all that stuff. But as you said, of course, they have all day. They Google it, they listen to it, they Google it, and they have 8-12 hours to throw it back in his face.
Well, I thought they did a good job. I thought Oberman also handled it well. He wasn't a jerk about it. He was kind of funny about it.
No, it was fairly...
It was a cute way he did it.
Fairly funny and fairly straight. Straightforward. Yeah.
No. But the O'Reilly stuff is even better. If stupid could get that. Why can't you get that, Bigfoot? Where are you now? Is there any way I could come back and beat on you?
Well, that would be a fun confrontation to watch.
Where are you? What are you doing?
Bring it.
Here comes Bowman into the ring. This will not be pretty.
This is insane. 27 half the hour. Well, Oberman was all over O'Reilly. It was kind of amusing.
You got to see it.
Yeah, it's funny. 27 out there. Apparently won't have it today, though. Well, watch Oberman tonight at 8. I'm Eastern time on MSNBC. Here's Vince.
About living.